Good morning and welcome to our live remembrance service, coming direct to you from our memorial garden here at Hagley Catholic High School. In our remembrance service today, I welcome especially those of you around school and to those that are joining us live from home, at work and in our primary schools. Today we remember those men and women who gave of their lives to protect our country, our democracy and our freedom. During the month of November, we also remember those members of the Hagley family who have passed away and the loved ones whom we have lost. We will spend time this morning in prayer and reflection. Take this time to remember loved ones, but also pray for an end to conflict and for peace and reconciliation to reign in our communities and our world. Let us begin our service together with the sign of our faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. At the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, the guns fell silent on the Western Front to bring an end to the First World War. Our nation and Commonwealth has recalled the moment through our armistice and remembrance events through the decades. Decades during which the men and women of our armed services have continued to pay the ultimate sacrifice. And so we stand here today to remember lives sacrificed in the service of our country and those traumatised and injured in conflict. May we have such a devotion to justice and freedom that the heroism of all who fought and who still fight may continue to be remembered in a nation of service and in a world of peace. They shall not grow old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. Thank you. when you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow we gave our today.
Ever-living gods, we remember those whom you have gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. May that same peace calm our fears, bring justice to all peoples, and establish harmony among the nations. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you, so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, and so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command: love one another. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We will now listen to our bidding prayers read by our head boy and head girl.
We pray for the leader of our church, Pope Francis, that he may continue to inspire us as the body of Christ on earth. May he remind us of the life which is intended for us and lead us to live a humble, peaceful life. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for the leaders of society. May they open their hearts to listen to God's word, so that they will make conscientious decisions, thinking of the lives of others before their own. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We ask God to bless us with the gifts of prayer and peace. Prayer and peace are difficult things to have in our lives. Sometimes they can make us feel vulnerable. Sometimes they can seem powerless. But when we join together in prayer and peace, we can become powerful beyond measure with God's grace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We thank God for all those who have laid for all those for us to enjoy our freedoms. We also remember our loved ones who have gone before us. May they rest in peace. We pray for their families here on earth, that they may be comforted by our prayers and by God's grace and compassion. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We ask Mary, Queen of Peace, to pray with us and for us as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgiving for all whom we remember this day. Fulfill in us, as in them, the purpose of your love, and bring us all to your eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us now pledge ourselves anew to the service of God and our fellow brothers and sisters, that we may be peacemakers in our homes, in our community, in our country, and in our world. Please join me now in saying this act of commitment. Lord God, we pledge ourselves to serve you and all mankind in the cause of peace, and for the relief of want and suffering. Give us wisdom, give us courage, give us hope, and keep us always faithful. Amen. And let us say together our school prayer. St. Nicholas Owen, make this school a safe refuge. Inspire in us a love of God and a love of our neighbour. Guide us in our work and play, that we may always be faithful to Christ our Lord. Amen. St. Nicholas Owen, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you for your respect and reverence this morning. To all those who joined us online, and to all those who helped to play a part in this act of remembrance. Think about how you can be inspired by the sacrifices made by so many to be of service to others and build a more peaceful and just world. May God bless us all.